Good morning, everyone. I'm excited to be here with you and to talk and share and just continue to speak about how we can multiply our lives into others. David mentioned I'm Joaquin. I'm a ministry apprentice here at ECHO. I also help lead ECHO students in the South Campus. So for us, the first principle we're going to look at, one of the main points is that you model the way you invest in others, right? One of the main teachings that we look at is kind of what Paul was sharing. One of the letters that he wrote to the Corinthians is that he shares with them, imitate me as I imitate Christ, right? He was trying to get them to go beyond just knowing everything, going beyond just saying, oh, I know what to do, but he said you should be able to live it out, right? If you live it out, then that's all you need to do for people to then follow you. That's the same way Jesus did. He walked with all his people. He was modeling the way for them to continue to follow his teachings. Felipe was speaking about Mark 3, and so as we continue that story in Mark 4, one of the things that happens is Mark records how Jesus used to teach in parables, right? He would speak to these large crowds. He would tell them these teachings about the kingdom of God, and then later on he would break off into small discussions with his leaders, right? And he would kind of explain to them what it meant, because not everybody was able to get it. And so in this moment, he actually shares the parable of the mustard seed, right? In this moment, he's sharing how this mustard seed is actually the smallest seed of the garden, where it actually grows into the biggest tree in the garden, right? So he's trying to give them this visual, this image of how their faith can grow. He's trying to show that if they start with just the smallest of faith, it can become one of the biggest and most amazing things. And so after he shares this, they end up hopping onto a boat, getting ready to go to the next area. In this event, there's actually all these storms that go on, and everybody starts freaking out. All the apostles are kind of scared, and as this is all going on, Jesus is actually below deck just sleeping, right? He wasn't even fazed or even bothered by this storm. And so as they record this story, what ends up happening is all the guys run downstairs, and they're like, Jesus, wake up, wake up, wake up. Like, we're going to die, right? Like, God, come on, right? And so the way they were yelling, they woke up Jesus and pretty much everybody in this auditorium, right? So they're just this tone of fear and death. They were so scared, but they didn't realize that Jesus was actually modeling for them right there in that moment, right? As all these storms are going on, Jesus was at peace, right? He wasn't worried. He knew exactly where he was going. He knew what God's plan was, and he was able to just kind of sleep through that terrible storm, right? So as they failed to see this model, they failed to kind of follow that model, Jesus would now have a chance to correct them, but more importantly, he was going to give them instruction and guidance. So when they woke him up, you know, he tells them, you know, like, why do you guys have such little faith, right? Why do you have such little faith? And he ends up going back on top, and he just calms all the storms. And they're amazed by this, and they're saying, like, God truly has all this power, right? Like, Jesus has so much power, we just really didn't realize it. And so it's easy to see in this story where, okay, these guys had this lack of faith, right? They were watching Jesus perform miracles, and all of a sudden, now they didn't believe he could handle these storms. And in a quick way of looking at it, that is true. But I think there's more to it, and there's more of why this story was recorded. And so as we look at it, it's actually important to understand that the majority of the apostles were actually all fishermen, right? They knew these seas. They knew all these waters. They knew the boats. They knew everything that these boats could withstand. And so when they see these storms coming, they knew that they couldn't make it, right? Everything in their natural being, everything in their mind, all their history and experience told them, there is no way we could do this, right? There's no way we can survive this. They were basically living out like the first Deadliest Catch episode, right? They were not going to make it. And so as they're scared, as everything in their body is telling them, now Jesus is showing them something special. Now he's giving them this instruction of what his power truly is, right? They've seen a little bit. They've seen all these small miracles as he's healing people. But now they're going to see him conquer the seas. They were going to see him conquer all these storms. And so now their faith could grow even more, right? It was a chance that they were tested to see what kind of faith they had. And now Jesus was going to instruct them more and more based upon how he was showing his power to them, right? So for most of us, it's important to see that, right? Modeling is one of the most easy things to do. And for me, it really does strike at home for me. My father used to do this all the time. He was a believer. He believed in having us all the time with him. He used to have his own business, and so we used to always come with him. It's kind of funny to share about how he used to model for us, because apparently my father was unaware of all the child labor laws, right? So he didn't know that it was actually wrong to bring your kid to like 10 or 12-hour work days, right, when they weren't in school. But he did it anyways, right? Because for him, he wanted to follow this teaching. He wanted to model the way of how you should live your life, right? So he's like, at business, they can see what kind of man I am, what kind of father I am, what kind of Christian I am in everyday life. And so I see, because of that, that's why I'm the leader I am today, right? All because of my dad. And so for me, I continue to look at those people and for leaders that are going to model the way for me. That's kind of what brought me here at ECHO Church. ECHO Church is really invested in church planters. They want to share experiences. They want to share wisdom, passion, and all these things to help equip us to then go out and start healthy churches, right? In this process, I get to meet with Felipe a lot. He shares a lot. He talks about different strategies, different experiences, but he also shares his personal life and how his faith works for him. And so one of the things that he shared right off the bat was how important prayer is, right? He was sharing that as a church planter, there's so many things that you're not going to be able to understand. There's things that you're not prepared for. There's all these obstacles that'll come up that'll prevent you from really going out and starting that church. And he was saying that for us, we have to really now be centered in our prayer life, really always looking to God for his strength, for his guidance, and even his comfort when things don't work out the way we want it to, right? But we have to trust that God is leading it, and that prayer life will really keep us strong and keep us committed to that call. And so as he shared this, he's given me this instruction, but what more importantly he was going to do was actually model it for me. So as I've continued to be around his offices, working with him, he always invites me to pray for a lot of different things, for people, for us.